It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest rider, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1618, recorded Thursday, April 13th, 2017. Bare Necessities. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we have three gadgets from Digital Focus, a Pepcom event. I go camping on my crappy corner, it is still magnetic, and a viewer video that is absolutely fantastic. All next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease.
Under pathology.
Rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now! It is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the arbiter of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir. And you?
I'm doing good myself. Doing very good. It's been a crazy week. I just got back from D.C. over the weekend.
Oh, that's right. You were everywhere.
Everywhere. San Francisco before that. Had a fantastic time. And yesterday was my full day back.
Oh, you went to like a secret Microsoft meeting or something,
right? I did. Yes. Yes. So I was embargoed until Monday. And it's come out. The thing that I was there to discuss was they are now allowing community members to upload. There's a big process to choose these community members, but they have chosen 9 community members from Minecraft to upload maps, texture packs, and skins to the Pocket Edition store, and they're going to do a revenue share with those guys, so those guys can make money off of the Pocket Edition version of the game, which I think is really,
really cool. Are you one of them?
No, I'm not. They were just telling me about it. It was basically a press thing. And so I fell in that category, but also I fell in the category of creators, and they just wanted to interface, basically to make sure they're like, this isn't going to make anybody mad, is it?
That we're like, oh, I see, okay.
Doing this, and it's like, no, people are going to be so happy about this. So, some really cool stuff. Yeah.
Then, of course.
I went out to DC, saw so many different monuments and museums and hung around D.C. for a few days for a friend's birthday. It was a fun time.
Oh, great.
And then this weekend, I'm heading off. My birthday is tomorrow, I think. Yes. And
oh, my gosh.
I'll be 28. And me and my parents and family are going to go camping. So I'm leaving tomorrow morning to go camping. So it's been this 2 weeks just turn into crazy travel time.
Wow. You can tell city boys and country boys. I think the worst nightmare of my life would be to go camping on my birthday.
Oh, really? Oh, man,
oh,
I love
camping. No. The only time I went camping was a bunch of boaters were going up river to go camping in the Adirondacks or something, and I went with them. And they had tents and coffee pots, and they said, you know, where's your equipment? And I said, I'm on a 26-foot boat with a shower, hot water, microwave, and VCR and DVDs. And you think I'm going to get off the boat to go in the woods? I said, I'll come in for breakfast, but I'm staying on the boat. Yeah, so I'm not a camping. I'm not roughing it in the woods.
Are
you sleeping out in the woods?
Yeah, in a tent.
Oh, my God. Oh,
no,
my gosh.
I feel like boating is very, well, it depends, I guess, on the boat. But I've definitely hung around people who have boats, like sailboats. And I feel like that's almost exactly like camping, especially if you don't have, like, power on board or anything
that. Oh, yeah, that is.
You know?
That is.
But, yeah. Yeah, so I'm going to go tent camping. I'm bringing Charlie. So I bought a few gadgets for him. He has a new harness. He has a new thing that'll screw into the ground
to keep
him there. And he
has a new... Don't lose your dog in the woods.
No, definitely don't want to do that. And also a bowl that I could like fold up, and so that if we go hiking, I can give him some water while we're hiking. So anyway, I went and bought some of those gadgets today, and I thought, we should do a crappy corner about dog stuff. This is why haven't we done this yet? This would be the perfect thing, and Charlie could both
be in it.
Yeah, exactly. So So yeah. Well, I guess let's jump into some gadgets.
Let's jump into the shelf and digital focus. The first gadget is one of the most bizarre gadgets, and I'll just, we have a little video from the company and a little video from me, but basically neither video I think explained it thoroughly, but this is the idea that you can use a finger to tap something and make something happen. And you know that every one of your fingerprints is different, but then the little section of under your fingertip, that also has a print. And then the piece under that has a print. And then your palm has a print. And so what they're saying is you have 23 individual prints on your hand, and they have come up with a device that as you touch this device with all these different parts of your hand, you can run your life. So that's the theory. And here's their video.
TapDo is a button with an integrated fingerprint sensor. It can recognize with which part of your hand you're touching it. TapDo connects to your smartphone via Bluetooth Low Energy. Once you've downloaded the app from Google Play or from the App Store, you can choose which part of your hand should trigger which action. For example, you can assign a different app to each finger and thereby create easy shortcuts for yourself. TapDo becomes your shortcut for almost everything. You can leave your phone in your pocket. You can wear your TapDo on your wrist or attach it to anything with a clip. Whatever you may end up deciding, your TapDo will respond to you without you even looking at it. Something that may help you in the dark or amidst traffic. Your TapDo can even save you from embarrassing situations. And you can use it for security-related purposes. When you receive your TapDo, you'll already be able to execute a variety of actions. These include music player, video player, catch a song, mute my phone, find my phone, track my position, order a pizza, call a taxi, time tracking, fake call, smart light, smart heating, smart plugs, and IFTTT. We will add many more actions to your TapDo in the future. For developers, we are providing an open API so that you can easily connect your systems and services to TapDo.
We're a team of passionate computer scientists, physicists, and designers.
We've been working on TapDo for more than 1 year now. On our journey, we have developed and tested several prototypes. The Android app is ready, and we are currently working on the iOS version. This January, we proudly presented TapDo at CES in Las Vegas. And now, we need your help. With your support, we can kick off production and start sending out the first batch of TapDos. We count on you.
In case we missed seeing what it looked like, just show that little video from Pepcom where the women holes went up for us.
Okay, here we go.
How do you charge it?
Oh, you didn't have to charge it. It has a battery inside, so it's a standard component, and the battery life is at least half a year. So after half a year, you would have to change it, but you don't have to charge it at all.
Okay, and it's a little cell phone,
it's just a little cell battery. Like watches.
Oh, okay, and this is what it looks like, the training. This is the training tool?
This is the app, and the app is connected to the other things, like, for example, to your smart lights or to your music player. And once you have done the setup, you can put your phone away, close all the apps, leave it on lock screen, so you don't need the phone. It just has to have a Bluetooth connection.
What are we watching him doing?
So this is Tim. It's our Kickstarter star, and he explains how our TapDo works, because we are live on Kickstarter at the moment, and yeah, this is what we choose as our marketing video.
Oh, I see. Okay. And what is this going to retail for?
On Kickstarter, it is 100 euros.
Which so is how much in US dollars?
It's about 108.
180 or 8? 108. Okay.
Yeah, kind of.
And when do you think it'll be shipping?
In September, we want to start shipping, and then we'll have our own online shop and sell it through retailers.
Okay. And the final thing is, how do you wear it?
You can use it as a single button, for example, for a smart home. In the car, you can glue it anywhere. We will provide it with a clip, so I can clip it to my clothes or to my belt. And we got this wristband for people that don't already have a wearable. You can just clip it inside there and then use it like this. It's very convenient.
Okay. pretty amazing. Hopefully, if you have a good memory, Tap Do. Dick DeBartolo, Maz Maddest Writer, coughing, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. I am sending, that man is making me a drink. No, that's the wrong drink.
No. Interesting. And I also feel like this would be perfect for, a performer almost, even. Like, you know, just anything. I mean, having the ability to use so many different things on a button and have that communicate with your phone, that's really powerful.
I worry that I would not remember. I was talking to the girl in the video, and she said, well, one thing is to assign fingers to jobs. For example, right, you have your music finger, and the top is to turn it on, and then the middle section is to advance the phone, and the bottom section is to change the volume. But boy, I don't even think I could remember 15. I don't think I could remember the 15 things my fingers are for.
Right.
But you might be. You know, you have a, well, now you're getting old.
I know.
I mean,
now,
you have a 27-year-old brain, but not for long.
Someone would look at my hand and go, you know, are you writing messages or something? No, I'm trying to remember what my Tap Do does. This one's pause. Okay.
Right.
This one's lock the door. Okay, there we go. Basically, what I'm thinking of is, you know, when you're out and about, and let's just assume instead of, because the technology of it reading your fingerprint, that's really interesting. I mean, that's, you know, what is really creating the whole system. But at a basic level, you've just made really just a remote for your phone.
Yes, yes.
And if you had a remote that just all it had was 20 buttons, you know, could that be useful? And those 20 buttons you could program to do anything. So 1 through 3, the number 1 would be play pause, number 2 would be skip forward, number 3 would be skip backwards. And so I could definitely see a lot of uses for just basically a remote for your phone to do all these various different things.
But you came up with it with a great thing, like Brian Brushwood.
Exactly. That's what I was just thinking. It's like,
yes,
we had the craziest setup in order for playing and pausing music. He had remotes built into his shoes. So if he tapped the back of his foot, and he would constantly do this throughout the show, he would tap his foot against his other foot, and then that would play and pause music during the show. And so, like, something like that, it was hacked together. The boxes that we use had to be aligned in a certain way because there's like a short through the cable. Anyway, you know, so something like that would just solve so many issues if you just had an actual remote.
Now all he has to do on the stage is tap his foot to his wrist.
Exactly.
So yeah, much easier.
It's
so much
easier. There we go. Oh, perfect. Okay. Oh, this cue is coming up. I mean, someone even joked in chat because on the live version of the show, I didn't cut to the video quick enough. And they said, switching the video. I mean, how crazy would it be
if
I
just,
know?
Chad forgot that it was his thumb that did the video switching.
Exactly. I thought it was my pinky. It's my thumb that switches the video over. I mean, all these things would be really, really helpful. And then the underlying technology that it uses your fingerprint is just interesting and cool.
No idea that there were 23 different prints on your hand.
I know. I guess, you know, you got these 4, and then times 3, if you do each section, there's 12, and then I guess 1 here, maybe, I don't know. I don't know where all 23 come from, but that's insane. Now, one thing that does worry me is
Apple.
I feel like, did it right with their fingerprint sensor. And what I mean is, your fingerprint data is never uploaded anywhere. It's stored on the device, and if you get a new phone, you have to train the new phone every single time. They don't upload your fingerprints to any server so that you have like cloud access to fingerprint stuff. And I feel like that is the right way to do it. I'd want to do a little bit of research with this just to make sure that is the same process that we're going through, that we're not uploading my fingerprint data to any server ever, because once that data gets
to
any third party, it is fair game for our U.S. government to use it however they want. I'd want to keep that in mind, and I just haven't done the research to find that out yet.
Okay. Okay.
So yeah, Tapdo. Now, do you think the $100+? That does $108.
How are they doing? Go to Kickstarter for a second. I have a link there. See how they're doing.
It looks like currently they were hoping to get $48,000, and they're at $39,000.
Oh.
So, and they still have 22 days to go. So most likely they are going to back themselves.
They're going to make their, they're going to make it. Okay. Okay.
Exactly.
But this is not one of those things like the 3D printer that we had, the $99 3D printer we had last week or the week before, where they had like $2.5 million.
Yeah, exactly.
You know,
not yet.
So there's interest in this, but not overwhelming interest yet.
No, not doesn't seem like it quite yet.
People may watch this show and go, I want something I can do 23. I want to do 23 things with just my hand.
Right.
So maybe they'll jump in.
Looks interesting. It's funny. There are pledge levels. Apparently, you can buy, if you want to, 30 of them. 30 tap dues for 2,550 euros, just in case that you want to do. That's about $2,700 US. Yeah, no, I don't think I want to buy 30, but yeah. The Kickstarter special is
$118. $118. Oh, okay.
It gives you an estimate. It says about $118, so somewhere around there for the Tapdo. Interesting product. I would say that I like it. I feel like it's slightly overpriced, but a cool concept. And I don't even know of a remote out there that just controls your phone. Like, if that's all it did, you know, do that. Cool. Moving on.
Okay. Number two, another weird thing. It's called Pixie. And the guy said, now, this is unlike any of your other Bluetooth tracking devices because Pixie creates a mesh network in your house to locate things. So he said they had a video online. So let's take a little look at their video to see about the Pixie. So this is it.
This is Pixie.
Here we go.
And these are your things.
Mom!
Not again!
Pixie keeps an eye on your belongings when they go missing. Like magic, Pixie Dust appears and allows you to quickly see the location of things.
Give me back my wallet, kid.
Yeah.
Our easy-to-use technology links the Pixie phone
that weird stuff
with what you value most. Find what's yours with Pixie.
Okay, so this is a tile tracker competitor, basically.
Right. Now, they claim that this mesh network that they're setting up, it's a little weird. So the woman showed me that when you lose something, you hold your phone up and you do a panoramic of your room.
Mm-hmm.
And within that...
So there's like an augmented reality.
Yes, it starts with augmented reality. Okay.
Right.
And then in that video, you saw those like dust floating in the air.
Yeah.
Right. So that they call that their Pixie dust. It's a little, little too cute.
Clap three times to find your Pixie. Yeah.
Yes, exactly. So you go to the Pixie dust, and then the Pixie dust turns into a graph bar, getting closer, you're on it. Now, the one thing about it that is kind of strange is you really have to buy two of them for $50 for the system to work at all because one of them gets attached to your phone.
Oh, so that's what the mesh network thing is. You have to have one attached to your phone.
One attached to your phone, and then you get one more to go on an item. I know.
Too complicated.
And then the same as is it tile?
Yeah.
At the end of a year, you throw it out.
Right.
Because
you just throw it away. Okay. Yeah.
Right. So it has a lot of things not going for it.
Yeah, I agree. Now, I mean, the big, so tile and tracker. To I have a lot of knowledge about tile because I use that one all the time. Tracker, okay. I've only seen really at trade shows. But to my knowledge, okay. you do not get any real option to easily see where it's at. So that's the only thing that I feel like Pixie has an advantage over is yes. instead of, you know, with my tile, I just hit it to make some noise. That's all I do.
Yes.
And I
right.
you know, walk around the house. But if for some reason it happens to be in the car or in a room that is sequestered or under a pillow or something like that, I can't hear it. So the thing that this would have going for it is it does give you a better idea of the location. Without sounds.
Yes.
Does that mean that I want to have one attached to my phone at all times? I don't know. I think that's a deal breaker for me because I don't.
Well, wait a minute. They're doing one. They're doing one thing. I don't know for how long. But first of all, it's only iOS, which is
a problem.
They should get Android running. Yeah.
Right.
They give you an iPhone case. With one built in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, your kit actually comes with the two Pixies, and it comes with a case that you slap the Pixie in, so it's not actually attached to your phone.
I gotta say, I'm getting tired of any product that requires me to put a case on my phone. I want to put my case on my phone. I don't want to put a second case. I don't want to have to deal with cases. I don't want, sometimes I don't want a case on my phone, or if I do, I want it to be the color, the style, the feel, the ruggedness. I just other people's cases just aren't doing it for me. Because who knows what type of plastic that is, you know, if it's drop resistant, they'll probably claim it is, but then I gotta give it negative points for that.
Okay. No Pixie dust for you,
no
pal.
Pixie for me. No Pixie for me. Now, yeah, I don't know. There are definitely situations when I could, because to me also, I've had such a, I understand what it's like to use a tile and I use it all the time and I lose my stuff all the time.
Right? Okay.
Because I live with it, I live with my tile every day. And so, you know, I don't have to have a tile attached to my phone in order for one tile to call my phone. The app just does it for me. And I'm not in a situation where the audio is a problem. Now, I could see, perhaps, you have someone who's deaf, who the audio feature just does not work for them. This would be a great product for that. But yeah.
That's interesting.
Anyway, we've discussed that, I think. Yeah.
Okay. Well, now you know.
Customers can decide.
That's right. I just want you to know there's yet another one, another finding device out on the market. A third thing is way easier to understand. So let's take a look at the Works semi-automatic driving tool.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Rider, and the Giz Wiz. Digital Focus, a Pepcom spring event. We're at Works. And what would you think about a semi-automatic drill? Okay, is that what this is called?
This is the Works SD semi-automatic screwdriver. And the bits are stored right on board inside the tool right here. So I'll show you.
Oh, wow, this is going to be good.
So you have your Phillips bit right here, and say you want to change it, you just pull it back.
Wow.
And advance. And then you've got a Phillips number two there. And advance again, and you've got a slotted. So all the bits are stored in this cartridge right here. So you can put in whatever you want. These are just hex shank bits. Pop it in, and then you're ready to go.
What does it come with?
So it comes with six right here. So two slotted, two Phillips, and two square. And then you can put in whatever else you need to put together that IKEA furniture or whatever. And then it also comes with this screw holder right here. Now everyone can kind of picture themselves fumbling for a screw. This holds it right here. And then as you screw in, it retracts. as you drive the screw. So no more fumbling around with that screw when you're trying to drive a screw.
And is this out now?
This is out now, yeah. You can go to works.com, amazon.com, and $39.99.
Oh, that's great. And do you know about how long it runs on a single charge?
It depends on your project. So this is the battery life. It's lithium battery, so you can keep it in your kitchen drawer, and it'll keep a charge for up to 18 months.
That is great. Yeah. And it's called the
Works SD Semi-Automatic Screwdriver.
That's it. I like it a lot. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Minutes writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at Works at Pepcom. Bye.
Oh, my gosh. Dick, every once in a while, there's a gadget that we show off that I want to buy immediately. And this is one of them. Holy cow. Is that not the coolest thing? So it looks like you have a cartridge and... How she was saying you could use IKEA furniture. I assume that, you know, those very standardized bits. You can pull one out and put one in.
Yes, exactly. So it comes with six, but if you don't use the hex drivers or whatever, she said, you know, Lowe's and Home Depot carry tons of other attachments that just go right into that little cartridge.
That's so cool.
Yeah, and you can actually manually spin the cartridge. There's an opening at the bottom in case you don't want to go through the... You sort of know the order they're in.
Right.
You can manually do it. Now, it's a 4-volt...
screwdrivers all...
Sorry.
Oh, yeah, no, that's okay. You can play that.
Okay, so this is on the Amazon page for
right,
this.
Okay, yep.
Audio
working. Even above your head or in hard-to-reach places. Keep up to 6 bits on board and switch between them with the slide action. It's all powered by a lithium-ion battery that stays charged for up to 18 months. Need an extra hand? You've got it. The Works SD driver with automatic screw holder. Get yours today.
The holder is really cool. I think that that was the kind of the other thing that sold me is what's keeping that bit in place is like this really interesting... like little armature that comes out.
Yes,
when
that
it's
holds the
far
screw
enough
and
out, it closes, and that looks so cool.
Yeah, and I should make a note because when I was looking on Amazon, I'm going, wait, isn't this? And then I realized there are two versions out. So the new one that we're talking about here is the X255, and there is an X254. Now, the 254, I believe, comes with an extra empty cartridge, so you can put in your own, you can have their bits and a separate cartridge of 6 with bits that you buy, but it doesn't have the screw holder. You're better off with the X255.
Yeah.
Oh, and it's, is it
39. It looked like it was more expensive. $8 more expensive. Get the screw holder thing.
Oh, no, wait. You are on the right one. The 255.
Yeah, that was the 255. I switched back over. So this is the 255.
Oh, yeah, okay. The 255 is only 31 bucks.
Yeah, and then the 254, which...
Oh, the older one, yeah, is 40 bucks.
It's 40. So, yeah, get the 255.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Now they do say it's not for like construction or you know
it's for
stuff around the house.
Right. It's for it's for trying to get that thing that wall hanging thing up that's gonna you know look good in your living room.
Yeah. Someone on Amazon asked how long does the battery last and the guy said I don't know how long it lasts but I was I put 22 hinges on new cabinets in my kitchen.
Yeah.
And I got all 22 screws times 3 on one charge.
Perfect.
So,
yeah. It's for putting together furniture. Yeah. It's for home projects.
Yeah, exactly. And an LED light too so that comes on. So if you're screwing in the dark, you have an LED light to lead the way.
That should be our show title, Screwing in the Dark.
And forward reverse switch for unscrewing screws.
I love it. I love this this product. I currently have a little hand drill all the time.
You have that thing to take battery screws out. What are you looking at this
driver.
For? What are
You're
you looking
right.
at this for?
I have the toy driver. Where is that? There
oh,
it
the
is.
The toy driver.
The toy driver.
That piece of precision equipment, and you're looking at this?
You're correct. This wonderful device that's...
Does it still run at all?
This update does not work. No, can't get it to work at all. Oh, you're correct. I forgot. How could I be so mean to the toy driver, a device that almost didn't even work until you put about 100 pounds of pressure on this, and then it'll start to work.
Get the works SD. I think that's your better choice.
Absolutely. I mean, as a person in an apartment, this is, just a single or a house, putting stuff up is a pain. You normally need about two people to put up something, an IKEA bookshelf or something, and something that can hold the screw in an actual easy to use way. That alone, not to mention the super cool action of switching between.
That's neat. Pretty neat. But what I love about that is you don't lose the bits. You buy a kit, even though a kit comes and it has little punch outs in the lid to put the bits in, you do end up losing them.
Yeah,
but if six of them are in the driver, it's very hard to lose them.
Right, I agree. So. And then also, there's plenty of projects I've had where you're doing something with a Phillips head 1 second, and then a flat head the next, and it's just like, oh my God, okay. Unscrew that, put the bit in, hold it just perfectly, screw it, and I hope you don't pinch your fingers. I mean, it's a pain. And for small projects, this is perfect. I've added it to my Amazon cart. This is going to be one of those that I buy.
Oh, your birthday's coming. Send that to your family.
Perfect.
I hope they're watching.
Yes, exactly. Thank you. Okay. Thanks, Mom and Dad. Okay, cool with that.
Very good. Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, that means we're moving from sane things you might want to Chad's crappy corner.
Chad's crappy corner.
Get it.
And
get
we
it.
Should add that sometimes they're crappy, but sometimes they're not.
And sometimes they're not. This is a medium. This is medium.
Medium crap.
Medium crap. I will say that I have two products, and both products can be purchased for under $15 combined. So pretty inexpensive products. And we have a theme this month, and that is gadgets with magnets. Magnetized gadgets. And I'm going camping this weekend, as I mentioned at the beginning of the show. Yeah, so I wanted to give myself a sub-theme. We got two themes, two gadgets, two themes. I wanted to find something that I could use while camping. So I thought that would be really fun. So I headed on over to my local REI and found these two gadgets. The first one is a bell. Now, you may be thinking that's kind of a silly camping gadget. What on earth could this be used for? But this is actually a safety device. I'm not joking.
For Charlie?
At all. No, this is a bear bell.
Oh, my God.
So, a fact about bears is that they do not like sound. In fact, one of the first things, if you ever encounter a bear, is to make as much noise as possible. Scream, yell, bang pots and pans together, and it may possibly scare them away. And so hikers will use bells, and they will put it on a pack, and as they walk, it will ring as they walk forward, and it should scare bears away with this bell.
Wow.
Yeah, exactly. So that's the safety.
Even though it's not like super a loud. Big clangy thing, they just don't like,
Nope, they don't like sound, and it also, it just alerts them that you're coming, if you're quietly
I think what
walking.
It is when the bear hears them, the bear goes, does this with their claws.
Exactly, and then it hurts.
And then they can't attack you.
It reminds them of the circus, and they go, I don't want to go back to the circus. Now, of course, a bell like this, as I'm moving it around doing the show, it's pretty annoying, the sound. So the magnet part of this gadget is the little cover that comes with this bell has a magnet that will attach to the moving thing inside. So I'm ringing it, and it's not ringing at all. So when you're not on the trail, you won't have to actually listen to the bell ringing back and forth. So you can see that this is with the cover on. There's no bell, and I can pull the cover off.
That is very clever.
Isn't that very neat? So I thought that was just a nice little gadget. This gadget could save your life, and it's only $3.95. Wow. $3.95 at REI. Sometimes it doesn't get caught exactly, and the, right. you know, because the magnet. So sometimes you do kind of have to let the magnet kind of find. There's a ball bearing inside, and then once it finds,
oh, okay.
it, then it's nice and.
Oh, there
and
you
secure.
Go. There you go.
Exactly. So that was my first gadget, the bear bell, that you can kind of stop from ringing whenever you're off the trail. And then right. next, this is just a fun and game item. When you're camping, there's not a lot to do. So what are you to do? Well, play some games. And so this is a chessboard with magnets built
oh
in.
Oh my God, backpack chess.
Backpack chess. And so you can set up a chess game. And, you know, Leo would probably love this. He's always playing chess.
Yeah.
It comes in a nice little plastic, sort of a hardened plastic container. And then each chess piece has some magnets at the bottom. And, of course, it folds out so you can keep the chess pieces inside and then unfold it to actually play the game. And so you have storage built in. And then each of these pieces can easily sit on the... on the board and then not move. They won't slide around once
they're
oh, wow, actually
that
on
is
the board.
Neat.
Isn't that neat? I thought that was a fun little little gadget for a little bit of recreation. Of course, I can. Setting up a chessboard is difficult. This cost only $11.95 for the magnetic chessboard.
In wow.
It works pretty good, I say. As you know, I shake it around, none of the pieces are moving or sliding around.
No, that's really neat.
Pretty nice. It's also, of course, now if you were actually backpacking, this may be a little bit heavy. I'd classify it as under half a pound, but every little bit matters when you're hiking. So this is probably more of a casual thing than just because of its weight. That would be my guess. Then you can just take all the pieces, throw it into the chessboard. There we go. Close it up. And
does it have black ones too?
They go, yeah, it does. Yeah, they're over here. They don't show up okay. quite as well on camera.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So
okay.
I decided not to use those. But yeah, right. here they are right there.
Know. Okay.
Take it, throw those in there, close it up. We got to set a few down. There you go.
Wow.
And now you're ready
neat.
To move. So, two magnetic camping gadgets for you. Both of these I found at REI. One is $3.95 for the bear bell and $11.95 for the chessboard. Here, amigo, let me just show you those product pages right
yeah.
here. There's the bear bell, and then, oh, apparently I have the bear bell twice. I don't have the chessboard.
Okay.
there you go. The chat room, of course, is going to do some research, and I bet they'll find these for $3
yeah,
each.
Yeah, they'll find one for 59 cents.
exactly.
And the magnetic chest thing for $1.30.
Exactly. Exactly. so there you go. We'll be back at it with Chad's Crappy Corner next week. With that, let's jump into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn! What do you got for
our gadget warehouse video is from a very young viewer. It's great that we have such a broad age group among fans. And she says, it's Jaden. She said, my dad filmed this for me. I want to tell you about one of my favorite gadgets. So, Jaden, show us your favorite gadget.
Hi, Nick and Chad. My name is Jaden. I'm 12 years old and I live in Texas.
Woo!
I'm a cheerleader, and during the hot months of August and September, at my cheer practice games, we were looking for something to cool us off. So we went on Amazon and we found these cool little fan things. And so they come in lightning port and micro USB, and they plug into your phone and give you a nice breeze.
Oh, cool.
And they run off the battery of your phone, and they're made out of rubber, so if it hits your hand, it doesn't hurt at all. And they come in multiple colors, and on Amazon, they come in one for $4.99, and three for $8.59.
That's perfect.
So that was one of my favorite gadgets. Bye.
Thank you so much, Jaden. That was perfect.
Jaden. And Jaden's dad sent us an email and said April 12th, what is today, the
13th?
13th. Yeah. Is when Jaden turned 12.
Oh, wow.
So, Jaden, happy belated
birthday. Okay. We're two days apart.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. That's
wow.
right. You will get, assuming you live in the U.S., I assume you do, you'll get, we'll be able to send June Mad to you. And an Alfred E. Newman picture, if you even know who Alfred E. Newman is. So email us, mail@gizwiz.biz. So, Jaden, send us your address there. And for other folks, if you want to make a video, and now you know, it can be pretty much anything. Your favorite gadget, like Jaden did, and a gadget that you have in your closet. A lot of people cannot throw certain gadgets out. Oh, Chad just went to the webpage there.
Looks like this is something similar. This one's one for $489.
So, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, there's all sorts. This is great.
Yeah.
Cool.
All right, so send us a video under 3 minutes and mail that too. Also, mail@gizwiz.tv. And pretty much anything that involves a gadget, we're interested in. Okay, so do that. We have, I think that you have one new video left.
Perfect. With that, let's jump into the letter. For the letters.
Our letter. Hi, Dick and Chad. This is from Mo or Moses, who's a frequent contributor to the show. And he found a gadget that at first I looked at the picture and I thought, I don't get this. And then I realized what it was. So he said, I saw this, was very disturbed by it. It looks like one of the outlet adapters that I have. I'll be taking a second look now if I see one of these in a hotel room or a home I visit. So this is it. I thought he was sent it in because it was a mistake, that it was an outlet surge protector for $369. But it's actually
a 1080p covert Wi-Fi camera.
Wi-Fi camera. So it's to look like it is a charging station, but it is also videotaping anybody who is using the charging station.
Yeah, that is, I saw a few of these. We did Spy not too long ago.
Oh, yes. Oh, did you see one of these?
In the Spy store, there was definitely a few products that looked very similar.
You know what I find weird about it is, these would tend to be mounted very low on the floor, wouldn't they?
Yeah. I think this is a whole category because they had these in the Spy store under what was called Nanny Cam. The idea is if you were afraid that someone was coming into your house and stealing stuff from you, you know, like a nanny or a housekeeper or something like that, you would use this to covertly record them. But of course, what I think Mo is saying, and what I think is a lot of people's minds, is that this could be used in some pretty not so
sneaky ways,
exactly, to put it softly.
Yes.
So yeah, definitely keep an eye out. I guess
so.
This is
the funny thing is, it's a real thing. I mean, it has two charging ports and it has
it
six
still works as a charger, right?
Right.
Interesting.
It is very weird when you think about it.
And it's on B&H Photo, which is like...
I know, that sort of is strange too.
Is there a hidden camera section on B&H Photo? This is actually, these are the products that I showed during the spy month. I use the Brick House Security Nanny Cam. But yeah, here's another that I swear I've seen this exact type of USB charger.
Wow, look at that.
1,000 times.
Me too.
Absolutely, yeah. Be vigilant.
So, yes, yes. So you could go into someone's house that you wanted to find out about what they're doing and saying, my phone is dead. Is it okay if I just plug it in for a couple of hours? Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. I left my phone, my charger there.
Look at this.
Yeah,
coat hook thing is kind of silly, right? You come home with a big coat and you hang it up and it totally covers.
Do you mind if I put my coat hook in your house? Just leave this on the wall. There we go.
Right. Can I hang your coat up for you? No, that's okay. I brought my own hook.
You know, let me just put it right here.
Leaving it here. So next time when I visit.
Is this where you do your banking? Is this the computer you bank from? Okay, one sec. Let me put that right there. Get a good look at the keyboard.
Can you sit down at your desk and take out your checkbook and tell me back?
Exactly. You type in all your passwords on this keyboard? Okay, there we go.
Radio Rod said they found spy cameras in tanning beds.
Oh, my gosh.
In an Indiana tanning salon.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, there's
Be vigilant.
Privacy left in this world.
I would say if you aren't using the charger, unplug it and put it on the ground. Yeah, exactly.
Hang your coat over it.
Use the coat rack. Use it. It becomes unusable. That's actually pretty funny. I'm going back and looking. It does seem if you put a coat on this coat rack, that little dot.
You're not going to see it. Yes.
It would be obstructed by the use of this product.
It's ridiculous. Can I use your coat rack? And they say, only the bottom hook.
Yeah, please, yes, use only the bottom hook.
And don't put a hat on the top or I won't be able to see you. I mean, I won't be able to.
It just wouldn't look great. It wouldn't look nice on the wall. Thank you so much, Mo, for letting us know that.
That was very good. Very good.
With that, we want to give you a big thank you to our patrons. We have a Patreon account. If you're unfamiliar with what a Patreon is, patreon.com is the place for people to support independent content creators like ourselves. Our Patreon is patreon.com/GizWiz. And that is where you can support the show, how that works. It's a reoccurring payment. Every time we do an episode, you would donate a little bit of money to the show.
It could be 50 cents.
If you get anything from this show, please consider giving a little bit back. And seriously, it could just be a little bit. We're not asking for $10 an episode or anything like that. Just saying. Patreon.com/GizWiz is where this is hosted. And big thank you to everybody who supports the show and makes this show happen every single week.
Our 101st independent production.
101?
Three more shows, and we have been supported to do this show for 2 full years.
Incredible. In 3 more episodes, it'll be 2 full years independent shows. And we seriously couldn't do it without our patrons and without your support. So big, big thank you to you. Some people don't want to do recurring payments. Totally understand that. We do have a PayPal link on our website, gizwiz.tv. And you can get to that link by clicking on the Patreon tab at the top. And navigating just underneath the banner there. While you're there at gizwiz.tv, you can watch the show live whenever we're live. We are live every Thursday around 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time. If for some reason we deviate from that plan, there'll be a banner at the top of the site that tells you our new recording schedule. Also there at gizwiz.tv, you can subscribe to the show in iTunes or RSS in a whole bunch of different formats, HD, SD, and audio, or on YouTube. There's also all of our previous episodes, the show notes, links to the gadgets, and also links back to our sister site, gizwiz.biz, which is run by Dickie D himself, and he writes up nice articles about every single gadget that we cover goes a lot more into detail than we do on gizwiz.tv. So you can check that out there. While you're at gizwiz.biz, check out What the Heck Is It? This is the game that we play where you have to figure out what gadget this is. We don't tell you. You have to figure it out on your own. And this is a whole gadget. This week, it is, to me, I mean, obvious. I mean, I'm not guessing here. I'm just saying that this is like one of those things that you use underwater to propel yourself, except it keeps you in one place. It doesn't go in any direction.
Okay.
Sends water out in three different axes and then just keeps you there, standing still. This is the Mad Magazine. This is the cover. The cover's been released.
The cover has been released of the June issue, which is what you'll be playing for.
Perfect. Nice. I like Alfred E. Newman's just bonking Trump right on in the eye with his mad microphone. And designated survivor, Rogue One. Is that the designated survivor? Like, you're talking about how there is a designated survivor in the U.S. government? Is that what that is?
Those are satires that are in the magazine.
Got it.
On the movie Rogue One and a satire on designated survivor.
Perfect. So that is the Mad Magazine that you're playing for. There's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers, but 24 are double the Mad Magazines for funny, hilarious, clever, interesting, and creative answers. So get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. That about wraps it up for this episode. I think we'll see you next week.
I'll be here.